The city of San Diego now doing its daily coronavirus update. Mayor Kevin Faulconer now speaking live.
Second, I will give an update on our beaches. Third, another successful expansion of our Slow Streets initiative. And lastly, of course, highlighting the work we've done all this week on San Diego businesses that are opening up and stepping it up and doing it the right way. But topic number one, bringing faster wireless technology to San Diego. You've heard me talk each day about what our community is doing to bring relief to San Diegans affected by COVID-19. We've been talking about immediate needs, like opening the convention center to get homeless individuals off the streets now. We talked about short-term needs, like directing more than $20 million for small businesses and extending the eviction moratorium for San Diegans that are struggling to help pay their rent. And longer-term needs, like pushing for a safe and responsible reopening strategy that puts San Diegans back to work. This next announcement is a little different because it's been actually more than a year in the making. But today we are launching a citywide expansion of next generation 5G wireless technology. As San Diegans are turning to the internet to work, learn, and access healthcare, this investment really comes at a critical time. This is a game changer, and it's possible because of our corporate partner, Verizon. San Diego is among a small handful of cities across the country to launch this technology. And we're getting it at a time where demand for reliable internet access has never been greater. Connecting with friends and families on Zoom, students that are now continuing their education while staying at home, business owners bolstering their online ordering and delivery options. This pandemic, of course, is transforming everything we do and how we do it. San Diego continues to lead in the forefront on adapting to this change. 5G technology is going to make everything we do over the internet faster and more reliable. In fact, it promises to deliver download speeds up to 10 times faster than the current mobile networks. This is a result of an agreement between the city and Verizon to accelerate 5G and enhance wireless service. We streamlined the permit process so Verizon can get the 5G into the hands of San Diegans faster and more efficiently. And as I mentioned earlier, I don't think this really could have come at a better time. Our healthcare system has carried a tremendous burden recently responding to COVID-19. This has manifested in a variety of ways, including a dramatic increase in online doctor's appointments and telehealth consultations. Rady Children's Hospital has gone from 20 telehealth visits per week to more than 4,000, 20 to 4,000. And other providers like Sharp and Kaiser are also conducting thousands of consultations each day with a similar increase in customer demand. So you're going to get a firsthand account during today's update on what this technology means in the healthcare industry from Dr. Magid in just a second, who's with Rady Children's. But the bottom line is that 5G is going to make it easier for our local businesses and residents to stay connected with faster and more reliable internet access than ever before. We are proud at the city to partner with Verizon to make 5G available to the healthcare industry, to businesses, and of course, our residents alike. So now, first up, it's my pleasure to introduce the West Area President for Verizon, Jonathan Lecomte. Jonathan, thank you for being here.
Well, thank you, Mayor. It is great to be here with you today. Today, I'm excited to announce that San Diego is the latest U.S. city to have Verizon's 5G ultra-wideband mobility service. Our launch of 5G marks an important milestone following the partnership that was formed between Verizon and the City of San Diego in April of last year. Our partnership is designed to create a more connected and forward-thinking city. We're building a robust and reliable network that will get cutting-edge technologies into communities faster and more efficiently than ever before. 5G will change how we live, work, and play. Cities that lead in the development of this new technology will be first to attract and keep tech-savvy businesses and create new technologies and high-paying jobs. Connectivity, as the mayor mentioned, is more important now than ever. With the realization that life during a pandemic requires distance learning and the ability to work from home for extended periods of time, and we're doing that and making that happen right here in San Diego. Our 5G ultra-wideband service will be initially concentrated in parts of Mission Valley, Linda Vista, Kensington, and Bankers Hill. But we will be rapidly expanding that footprint throughout 2020 and beyond. We appreciate our partnership with the City of San Diego, and we look forward to bringing Verizon's 5G ultra-wideband service to more neighborhoods in the near future. Thank you. Thank you.
Jonathan, thank you. And next up, it is my pleasure to introduce Rady Children's Hospital physician and telehealth lead, Dr. Anthony Magid. And Dr. Magid can talk a little bit about telehealth and how important it is for this new connectivity. Dr. Magid, welcome.
Oh, thank you, Mayor, very much. It really has been important. In the past several months, Rady has gone from a handful of telemedicine visits today to over 600 per day, really involving all our specialists as well as developmental services and our primary care physicians. And it's really critical because if parents can't bring their children onto our campus for either routine care or urgent care, it could be potentially a crisis. And one of the real concerns is that people are having routine care deferred because of the concern about leaving their homes. So the ability to access the internet in real time and a reliable network is critical, because during an examination, a discussion with the family, you don't want to have technical issues become a problem. So we really see that telemedicine is becoming a significant part of healthcare even once this pandemic has resolved. And having reliable access to the internet is critical, especially for those who don't have broadband who rely upon smart devices. So we're very excited about this and really appreciate the opportunity to work with San Diego as a community as your pediatric safety net.
Thank you, Doctor. Thank you, Doctor. And we had a chance a little bit earlier to talk about all the just outstanding work that continues every single day at Rady Children. So thank you. I really appreciate it. Great partnership. Topic number two today, lifting some of our current restrictions at our local beaches. We know that folks have been waiting to get back to a little more normal on the beaches. And I want to thank San Diegans again for doing the right thing, following all of the procedures. You've been patient, you've been cooperative, compliant with our lifeguards and with our SDPD, who's been out there on the front lines of this since day one. It's all been done, of course, to help protect the spread of the virus. And so with that, we're prepared to loosen some of the restrictions with the goal of keeping us safe under this new normal. Starting this Tuesday, June 2nd, sitting on the beach will be allowed for sunbathing and relaxing with your household unit. Activities that are not allowed are sporting activities like football and volleyball. That is some welcome news. I think that'll be great. Again, that starts on June 2nd. Also, per the county, beach parking lots are going to remain closed for the time being, as well as piers. As we have this additional opportunity to use the beaches, I will say, as I always do, it's important that we follow the new rules here. Keep that social distancing while you're on the beach and sitting down. We have not given back any of the gains that we've made. We're not going to start now. San Diego continues to be a model for cities, as I've said before, across the state and across the country, for how to do it right on our beaches. Thank you for doing the right thing. On June 2nd, I have no doubt that we will continue to do the right thing to help us move into other phases. We're doing a good job, San Diego. Let's keep it up. Topic number three today, the successful Slow Streets Initiative. Just a few weeks ago, announced that Slow Streets Initiative. And through this program, we are closing select streets to traffic to give residents more space outside their place. We've seen phenomenal positive reaction from the five existing locations that we've installed slow streets, from Pacific Beach, Normal Heights, North Park, and two in Emerald Hills. Folks are able to get out of their homes, walk around their neighborhood, take a bike ride, and all with more space to safely practice physical distancing. And of course, get the much needed fresh air. Thank you to everybody who has submitted your feedback on the slow streets. And because of that, we're expanding the program. Our teams are in the process of planning 100 additional blocks for slow streets across the city, which would more than double the current slow streets that are already in place. We're expanding more so San Diegans can safely practice physical distancing and enjoy their neighborhoods in confidence. Materials for the additional signage and barricades are already on their way. We hope to have more installed and open these slow streets throughout the month of June. I've been working with city council members and community leaders to identify locations that will make great slow streets. But I also want to hear from you. And so if you have a slow street in your neighborhood, or if you want to, if you have an idea for a slow street in your neighborhood, or you want to talk about how much you're enjoying an existing one, you can go to the website that's on the screen, sandiego.gov/slowstreets. Fill out a quick survey. Let us know your thoughts and how we can help bring this really, I think, cool amenity that San Diegans are using to even more neighborhoods. Topic number four, finally highlighting the work that San Diegans are doing as we are reopening our economy. We have transitioned to stories, obviously, about focusing on businesses that are doing it and doing it in the right way. Earlier this week, offices began to reopen, and that included the downtown workspace. This company is a shared workspace that offers offices and meeting spaces for San Diegans to utilize, along with accelerators and other business networks. They've created a collaborative and a creative environment for entrepreneurs, writers, freelancers, and startups. With many working from home right now, the folks at Downtown Workspace know that there are a lot of people who would love a change of scenery. You can see there on the screen, their team is taking all the right measures to keep their employees and members safe. Required temperature checks and face coverings, plexiglass to separate offices, regularly scheduled cleanings, directional signs and distance markers to help people maintain physical distancing in group areas. They're doing things right. And these measures are making it health and safety for San Diegans a top priority. And because of businesses like Downtown Workspace, people that are following the rules and are opening responsibly, we can continue and we will continue to move along in the phased reopening approach. Again, congratulations and keep up the great work. All of our San Diego businesses and companies for showing the right way how to do it. With that, I will pause and happy to answer any questions from members of the media.
And today's first question comes from Mike Freeman with the Union Tribune.
Hello, Mike. Oh, thank you. Can you hear me?
Mike Freeman's question was, what neighborhoods will get 5G next after the initial rollout in Mission Valley, et cetera? And what is the time frame for citywide, countywide coverage?
Great question. Jonathan, want to come up and maybe ask that? Thank you.
The intent is to move as fast as possible, and a good example of this is in Chicago. We've actually already doubled our footprint in the Chicagoland area, so we are moving very rapidly. It still is going to take many months and potentially a year or so to build out all across the San Diego community, but the intent is to do it as soon as possible.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Thank you. I mean, that was our only question for today. Thank you. Again, thank you to the folks at Verizon. Thank you to folks at Rady Children's for a great example of how important telehealth is. Thank you, San Diegans, for continuing to do the right thing. And I look forward to tomorrow's update. Thank you.